Ladies and gentlemen, let us all be upstanding. Let us all be upstanding. Take the beat down. Take the beat down, please. Let us all be upstanding as we welcome into this magnificent hall the most beautiful, the most elegant 80th birthday celebrant in the world at the moment, Mrs. Oluwafemisola Flora Ogudile. Make some noise.
Shemila yan fere kemi lesin adopin titila Shemila yan today oh, I will lift up my voice in prayer, for I know you are almighty God. Success come up, I will pray. Today, oh, I will lift up my voice. Today, oh, I will lift up my voice. Today, oh, Kajo, Kajo.
Etiqueti, Emma Que 90, Equi 100, Loruka Jesu, Equi 110, Ati 120, Nitori, Mommy, just for 2 minutes, yo, Mommy, yeah.
Now, it takes a lot to have been on Earth for 80 years. And not just to be on Earth, but to be here and look amazingly elegant. Very, very graceful. Very beautiful. I can see the steps, Mommy. And that goes without saying, because I've been told that you're a dancer. You love to dance. Somebody spilled the beans. So, by all means, I would want to see Mummy.
I think it's quite, I know we've got strict time limits and it's quite difficult to say everything about Mom in 5 minutes. But I just want you all to turn and look at her. And this is an amazing woman, a resilient woman. See, my dad has been dead now since 1984. And Mom has looked after 5 children basically by herself. And you know, it's such an honor for us all to be here and celebrate her. And you know, I don't want to say much really, because you know, I don't think words can quantify how much I really appreciate my mom. When I went to Nigeria for the first time in 1981, I hated her. I thought she was a dragon. It was a terrible experience for me, but you know, looking back as a mature woman, I think it was the best thing that happened to me going back to Nigeria, because it taught me so much about life. And we suffered. And I will say suffered with a capital S. But you know, bad times never last forever. And I just want us all to be upstanding and celebrate this great woman, this great mother, who even now in my ministry ministers to the single parents in my own ministry. And I just want, you know, just want to say, Mom, in front of everybody, I really appreciate you. Thank you so much for being there for me and my siblings. Thank you for suffering for us. Thank you for not abandoning us as so many other women would have done. You decided that you'll be married to your children and Jesus. And I know my siblings are right behind me as we just want to say thank you, Mom, for being there. You deserve this and more. We love you and you are a great mother and you are a great example. Thank you, Mommy, for everything. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you.
Please, ladies and gentlemen, let me just sound a note here. And that note is that it is a very, very joyful day, yet very, very emotional day. It would be, because people would not have gone through 80 years eating and dining and whining and having fun all through those years. It never happens to anyone. So, please, kindly assist me in giving a humongous round of applause to Pastor Mrs. Iwalola Olabi. I will say this in Yoruba. Bibeli wipe komore. I'm waiting for the response. Oh, komore. For the benefit of the English speaking guests tonight, the Bible says, train your child so that child can give you peace. Mummy, for your first child to be at your birthday party and kneel before God Almighty and yourself to thank you, to appreciate you. Mommy, you've done well, Ma.
You have done well, Ma. We praise you.
Mo dupe lowo Olorun. Birthday mi osoju e ni.
A beautiful round of applause to Mrs. Wedamosi. Thank you very much, Mommy. Thank you, Ma. Thank you. Thank you, Ma. Thank you.
Baye ba fun elo bi o ma ma de o Baye ba fun eni siga ko ma ma mu
You know, words can't really describe, but you know, my siblings know, you know, we know. And even during, you know, the thing is, even during the when things are really hard, my mom was always cheerful. She was always cheerful. She always kept us together and, you know, kept us strong. And one thing I can say about my mom, she is very prayerful. She loves the Lord with all her heart. And there are very few people that I know that can pray like my mom does. You know, she loves the Lord dearly. Regardless of what we were going through, she never gave up. And I just want to say, you know, we love you, Mom, from the bottom of our hearts. We thank you for all that you have done, bringing us up, you know, after our dad passed away. My mom didn't even have another relationship. As my sister said, we were her relationship. Though I think if she did, we would have given them a hard time anyway. But, you know, from school to university, you know, she just took us through it all. And as I can say, you know, look at us all today. It's because of our mom. Yeah. It's because of our mom. And I'm sure many people they hear today, you know the kind of person our mom is. She would go far and wide to see people. I mean, recently we were talking about my mom when she went all the way to Barking. Our mom lives in Tooting, on the tube, all the way to Barking to celebrate with someone. She's always celebrating with people. Always celebrating. You know, at 80, she gets on the tube to visit people to celebrate. But that's the kind of person she is. And, you know, I really would like to be like, you know, to take on those characters of my mom. And we just want to just thank you, Mom, for all that you've done and all that you even continue to do. Even now, you know, our mom, she never gives us any trouble. Even, I remember we were talking about when Mum was ill very recently. She didn't even call any of us. And then when I got a call 2 hours later, oh, I didn't want to bother anyone. And that's the kind of mum we've got. She doesn't want to bother anyone. And she just wants us to stay together, love one another, keep in touch. My mum will call you up and say, have you spoken to your sisters? Have you spoken to your brother? That's the kind of person she is. And we just want to thank God for our mum's life. 80. She's in good health. And we pray, Mom, that, you know, you will continue to live long in good health and that the good Lord will continue to protect you and be with you. We love you, Mom.
A round of applause for Sister Wendy. What does it feel like to be grandma's first grandchild?
Wonderful.
Wonderful. Beautiful. So, what would you say in your life is the most, is the greatest impact she's made in your life as a person, as a young man, growing young man?
Grandma's always taught me to be very joyous. Whenever I see grandma, she's always smiling.
That's all. Have the microphone.
The fact that she's so joyous that every time I see her, that she's always smiling, that she's always, whenever she greets someone, even through that little greeting, you can see the joy that she brings, the happiness that is in her heart. We shouldn't take it for granted because that's a blessing from God. It shows that she has a truly joyous heart and a joyous soul.
The question I have for you, not for you actually, I've got for your two big sisters. So I'm going to go to them and ask that question about you. Okay? So just give me a moment. Was she number three?
Yes.
She number three?
Yes.
Was she trouble?
Not at all.
Okay.
The troublesome one is yet to come.
Okay. Do you agree, Sister Wendy, that she is in any trouble?
No, not at all.
Not even as a three-year-old? Not even as a toddler?
No, I think it was more that was me. I was jealous of her.
Okay, a round of applause to for Lashade for being a very peaceful number three. Okay, so let us hear from her what she's got to say about her beautiful mom.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. So I agree. We love our mom. Mom is wonderful. Mom is fantastic. You know, I'm very happy, mom, to be here, to be talking about you. But it's time to tell the truth about how mom was when we were growing up. So, when we were growing up, mom was wicked. Mom, she was wicked. I remember mom has a fantastic personality, and you know, when we were growing up in London, she didn't allow boys to even get near to us. So I remember, there was two instances I remember. There was one when somebody came to knock for us, because in London in those days, they would come and knock for you to come to school. So there was this guy called, his name was Duck. And he would tuck his socks in his trousers. And, you know, he looked a bit unusual. So one day he came to knock on the door. He said, is Ewa coming out? Is Ewa coming to school? So unfortunately, mummy was passing. I think she was just, you know, passing. And she saw him. She started marching to the door. She said, "What? Don't you ever come to my house again." And we just thought, oh, my goodness. What are you doing? That was the first incident. Second incident was, we were all in Nigeria. We used to have this balcony, and we used to kind of just chill out there. So we're just chilling out. And then mommy was going to church, and she was wearing her sutana. So we used to, you know, obviously we didn't like our friend to see her wearing her sutana. So one day she just, she came out, she said, "Ewa, Wendy, Shade," because Titi was very small at the time, and Moses too. She said, "I'm going to church." And we kind of ignored her. And then 5 minutes later, she just came out. She said, "Wendy, Shade, I'm going to church. Am I speaking in French?" Now, so those were the two incidents, and she kind of chased our friends away. Mommy had a very funny way of dealing with Titi. That's the naughty one who'll be coming soon. And Moses, because they were terrible, terrible, terrible when they were growing up. So mommy would wait until they were sleeping, and then she would give them some, you know, some good floggings. Mommy was so funny that, you know, when you go out with her, and I remember once we were in the supermarket, and somebody said, "Oh, excuse me," and she just turned around, she just said, "Please." So, mom, if any of us are troublemakers, we got it from you.
Oh my goodness. I actually thought that was never gonna come. I've been waiting. Please, a humongous round of applause for La Chardin. It takes a lot of boldness to tell the truth. You know, I've been listening to Auntie Ewa and Sister Wendy, like, okay, somebody's gonna spill the beans. And somebody did. So thank you so much for saving us all. Because that was really beautiful. Look, African mothers are special people. So please, if you've got an African mom, please just appreciate them by giving them a round of applause. She paid £5 for this ghillie. She tied this ghillie herself. So mommy, what shall we call the ghillie? You want to give it a name. What does that mean? Oh, I see. Mommy's hairstyle is called bagbon. In other words, break a coconut. Mommy, how does that even relate? But let's hear your speech, mom.
And gentlemen, good evening, all good people that are here today. We are so happy, it's a very happy occasion for us to be here today. Some from America, our big auntie from America. This is our big auntie, oh, older than every one of us. She is the same mother with Auntie Femi. She's the most senior. So there she is. So she's still, you can see how we are the celebrant today, got a baby look. So we thank God for the good children. That they, we have to say that we thank God for the good children that God gave to Femisola. We have to thank God for the children. And they really, really, really behave themselves. They are really good children. Even when they say one is troublesome, no. There has to be a child where when children are growing older, there will be the young one, the most young one that we look deep for, that we behave. So that is normal. It's very normal. So I give excuse for anyone that is troublesome after them. Yes, So ladies and gentlemen, we thank God for the children, we thank God for their husband and their wife, we thank God for all of us, and we thank God for our sister, for her endurance. Her endurance, her hard work. If it's not hard work, if she's not doing things with hard work in her mind that I must make these children great, she won't be here today. So what she has done then, she has done it for herself. That is what she's reaping today. Maybe she would have been dead if she ignored the children and say, me le kujo, maybe she would have been dead. But she continued. So we have to thank God for her as well. So we thank God for everyone. Thank God for all of us. Thank God you are 80, you'll be 90, and you'll be 100. It's in the gene. So she has to be 100. Our mother was more than 100. So thanks all for coming.
Thank you.
Enjoy yourself.
Oh, Titi Lalami. Ayakwele yeju ye ni humagwe. Ine yonzo tenjola. Lajo Josio. Be 15 years ago. Nilu Bishop Stotford. Fi shara logbo unsoke ni be o. Ni kwende no. Ajo na rebia no. We thank God for his mercies, yo. We thank God for grace. Oh, da wa si ojo mi soju emi wa olalaye lo ni temi titi ayalola abi gbeyin mama o olalaye ni won ma pe ya riri lo se ma se ni so ma se ni so
Hello everyone. When my mum told me that I was doing a speech, at first I wasn't impressed because it was last minute and I was thinking, what am I going to say? But as I sat down and thought about everything, I've lived with my grandma, so I have a lot of memories, some funny ones, some that weren't so funny at the time. And I just want to share some of those memories so you can understand what my grandma is like. When my brother was first born, when he was really young, and my grandma lived with me, at the time I was in secondary school. So there were times I wanted to be a bit naughty. School would be finished and my friends would say, oh, let's quickly go here, let's quickly go there. So I called grandma. I remember one specific time I called grandma on the home number and I said, grandma, I'm just going to stay at school to do some sports. I'll only be an hour or so and then I'm going to come home. So if you don't see me at the normal time, you know, don't worry. And that don't worry meant don't call my dad, don't call my mom, because they know I'm not doing any sports. But grandma knew and she called my dad. My dad called the school. And then my dad called me and I had to go straight home and explain myself. So, my grandma, she's very caring. She knows all of us really well, and she can always tell if someone needs something uplifting said to them or something along those lines. I'm really grateful for the type of grandma that I have because, like everybody has said, she's very prayerful. Anytime she calls me, she prays for me. She remembers everything I say to her. My business, she's always praying for my business. She's always, my mum told me one time she was handing out my leaflets around in the area. So that just shows how much she wants me to be successful, and I'm really grateful for that. Regarding my brother, she looked after my brother really well. My brother didn't go to nursery, so grandma was his nursery, and she sang to him. He's really clever, so clearly he had a good start. There was a time that Christopher was playing in the house, and he still does it now. He'll play in the house and you won't know he's in the house because he's just doing his own thing. And grandma ran outside the house, and I live in a quiet village, not a lot of black people there, so she ran outside the house and started screaming and looking for Christopher all over the place, but he was just upstairs hiding. But again, it just shows how caring grandma is, and she never wants any problems. And I'm just grateful, really grateful for the grandma that I have and all the prayers that I receive. And I pray that I get to enjoy my grandma for many, many, many more years. And that I can share more stories with you. I could share more now, but I don't want to take everybody's time. But I pray that I get the opportunity to do this again. And my thing is, thank you.
Is there anybody here who went to school with mommy? To school? Ah, mommy, I've been looking for you.
How was things back home?
Thank you very much,
well,
a round of applause for our
ladies and gentlemen. Say, Shara. You're my brother. Well, you're new, my queer. I told you, Shadow, Baba Lola. I told you, Moses, Moss. Oh, good to heal a yellow little mimos. Oh, con la, why any woman girl? If what the animals wow. Now, where's okay, Kingly? Fine ball. Oh, Jamala, oh, I'll see you later on the dance floor. Etta, you titty, lala, me, Bello. I assure boy, yellow need to me, Shola, Shola, fine boy Shola, I a titty lola me oh, fine boy Shola, I a titty lola me oh, fine boy Shola, I got titty lola me. Fine boy Shola, oh konti ti lola. Moraya, lori gidi, lora ojo aji.
And he has been called several times. We've done some rearrangement. So, may I invite, please give her a resounding round of applause, because I can see the joy she brings to this family. Please welcome with me none other than Mrs. T.T. Lolani Bello! The coolest, the calmest, and the most collected. Exactly. A round of applause to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you all so much. It's a pleasure to be here. So my sisters came with wonder and sorrow. So basically, the truth is, they've been telling lies about me. I'm a gentle girl. I'm very, very gentle. But I'm going to go straight into my speech. No one can rush. Yeah, you rush. So everybody has 5 minutes. I'm going to take 7 minutes. Because I am going to say, I'm going to talk about my mom. But before, let me just go into my speech. Thank you all for coming. It's been wonderful having you here. If you're here, you're very special. If not to my mom, at least to one of her 5 children. Thank you for coming here today. Now, let's play a little game of truth or dare. No, not truth or dare, sorry. True or false? True or false, let's get into it. And it will give you a little bit more flavor about my mom. So true or false, my mom's wears like a trooper. Wendy, what do you say? Shade, what do you say? That is the truth. That is the truth. True or false? My mom gave birth to three of her children born on the 19th of different months. So 19th could either be a special date or not true. The 19th, true or false? True. That is true. That is true. True or false, my mom taught me how to fight physical. True or false? How to fight physical. Yeah. True or false? That is the truth. That is the truth. We just moved to Nigeria. We moved to Nigeria, and obviously I was about 4 or 5. I had an English accent, and I was being bullied in the local school. And one day, you know, you go home, and you tell your mom that somebody has been picking on you. And a normal mom would say, we'll go to the teacher, we'll tell the teacher about it. My mom said, hey, look, this is what you do. Hold your hand. So, the weightlifting obviously came from somewhere. Yes, my mom did teach me how to fight, and I'll never forget that. How to defend myself. Now, to my mom. A lot of you don't really realize how quirky my mom is. And everyone has talked about how wonderful, lovely, and she is, but she's also really, really quirky. During the process of planning this event, I had to call my mom and say, Mom, what is the order of your name? Is it Oluwafemisola Flora Ogunduile, or is it Flora Oluwafemisola Ogunduile? My mom started laughing. She said, of course not. It's Oluwafemisola because the Flora was the name that she gave herself. I said, how did it happen that you gave yourself Flora? She said, well, the colonial masters came, and yes, it was back in those days. The colonial masters came, and they wanted to baptize them, and obviously to give them all new names, English names. And so my mom had to choose an English name, and my mom chose Flora. And in my mind, I'm thinking, you chose Flora. Why? And my mom said, well, Nnamdi Azikiwe's first wife was called Flora. And she said she wanted to be named after a Gbajumo. And so she named herself Flora. So that's my mom for you. If you also look very closely at my mom has tribal marks. Now these tribal marks were not given to her at birth. These tribal marks my mom went and paid for as a teenager, because they were in fashion at the time. That's how quirky my mom could be. And when I was younger, one of my first memories of my mom was her bringing butterflies. I know. Every other mom comes back home with sweets. My mom came home with butterflies. I'm not sure if my brother remembers this, but she used to bring us butterflies from work in little cardboard boxes. But I have to say, that used to really excite me. You know, when you have nothing, the littlest and the simplest of things can bring you so much joy. And I used to love that. My mom has taught me so many amazing values over the years. And as I grow older, and as she grows older, I realize that we have much more in common than I actually thought we did. And all the things that used to annoy me about my mom, I actually see myself practicing them now. So my mom, as somebody already said, is patient to a fault. To a fault. Like I would call my mom and I would say, you need to stop speaking to X or Y. And you know, my mom brought us up in a way that you can talk freely with her, and she will listen to your advice if it makes sense. So I can easily call and say, Mommy, you need to stop talking to Mrs. So-and-so or Mr. So-and-so. I'm not going to mention you. They are not here, we thank God. But, you know, so I would say, you need to stop talking to Mrs. So-and-so. And my mom would say, calm down. And she always says, because I keep quiet doesn't mean I'm stupid. Because I keep quiet, it does not mean I'm stupid. And I'll be talking in the background. She will say, listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me. My mom is lovely. She's lovely. You know, one of the values that my mom instilled in me is not being fazed by anything that anybody has. And you know, this is such an important thing. And you know, it probably wasn't so much so important in her time as it is in my time. In my time where everybody wants more and more and more, and sometimes we're running ourselves ragged, looking for more, chasing more, more. My mom taught me to find the joy in the simplicity. So, you know, people have touched on the when we're growing up and the poverty, and it was true and it was real. And I want you to think about something. As we're growing up poor, my mom was also surrounded by her friends who were extremely well off, who were doing very well. And they used to come, and they used to come to our house to visit with bags of rice, and they used to give us money, and, you know, I'm not going to mention names, but if I was here, I remember the bags of rice. You know? But in all of that, my mom taught us to not be fazed by what anybody has. And that comes from an inner strength. That comes from a strength of knowing who you are as a person. You know, that comes from a self-sufficiency, knowing that what you are is not tied into any material possession that you have. And that is an abiding value that I have till today, that I respect, that I love, that my mom has shared with us. So, my mom used to also say something that I love, and she used to say, no condition is permanent. My mom used to say, you know, in the thick of being poor, there were days where we went without food, and I was very dramatic. I was a dramatic, you think I'm dramatic now? Oh my God, I was dramatic then. So back in the day, we would have no food, I'd be hungry. Some days I would start crying, and then we had this beautiful mirror, because remember that we came from London. So we brought loads of stuff from London. Stuff that couldn't fit in one bedroom flat, face me, I face you type of flat. But we had them in our face me, I face you. We had a beautiful portmolio. What did they use to call it? Portmanteau. We had that. We had a beautiful gilded mirror. Beautiful. So when I was you remember that? Yeah, you remember. Moss should remember that, because he wore a lot of girls' clothes in front of that mirror. Moss should remember that mirror, because in front of that mirror, Moss wore my mom's clogs. That may be where the shoe thing came from. But my mom used to say, no condition is permanent. And I remember that when I was really, really hungry, some days I would start crying. And I would start crying and crying, and I knew there was no food coming, but I was still crying. And then after a while, I would get in front of that mirror, and I would just be looking at myself crying. I'm looking at myself, feeling myself crying, just crying. It was amazing, you know. But my mom used to say, no condition is permanent. And sometimes when I'm going through difficult moments, I think back and say, no condition is really permanent. And I look back now. My mom used to say, we'll look back and we'll laugh at those days. And we look back and we do laugh at those days. But I also look back and sometimes I still cry at those days, because poverty does leave scars. And so I want you to remember that poverty leaves scars, and we still come from a country that is really, really poor. Regardless of how much the middle class is growing and how much we have, we still live in a country where there's still millions of children going to bed every night crying. So I just want to leave you with that. Now, one of the first memories of my mom being angry, and I said I'll take 10 minutes. One of the memories, my early memories, the first time my mom was being angry, it was Moss that got me into this trouble. So Moss and I, we have a very sweet tooth. We still do. If you leave a packet of sweets and if you give us a packet of sweets and you say, give our kids, we'll eat them before they get there. So my mom didn't have money to give us pocket money, but there was a lady that used to sell sweets around the corner. So Moss and I'm sure it was Moss's idea, we used to go to this lady and we used to get sweets on credit. And we told her that my mom said we should get the sweets on credit. And we built up a ridiculous amount on credit. So when the lady finally told my mom, she was mad. mad. Now I'm gonna end. My mom is funny. She has a wicked sense of humor. If my mom is similar, I'm similar to my mom in this respect. I feel people's aura. So I can meet you and just not like you straight away. I'm very sorry, I got it from my mom. But when I was growing up, and even till today, my mom will meet someone and I will know exactly whether or not she likes that person. If that person leaves the house and my mom says, that means my mom does not feel you. My mom is not feeling you at all. So I'm gonna leave by saying that I also grew up in a house full of music and songs. My mom used to sing all the time. She would sing songs like Ogoyi, Oluwa, Ye Ogoyi, Mashe Jeko Baje, Mashe Jeko Daru. Mashe Jeko Baje O Oluwa. Talo ye ka fope fun Jesu ni ka fope fun. Talo ye ka fope fun Jesu ni ka fope fun. Ka fori bale fun ka faya bale fun. Ka fori bale fun ka faya bale fun. Ifetani, lawa fi walaye. Thank you so much for being here tonight. Thank you.
What an amazing speech. Please give her a humongous round of applause. I hope for posterity's sake that the camera was rolling. I hope it was rolling.
It was rolling all the way.
Please, it must be rolling. Because we would never have that. Well, even when mom clocks 90 and 100, that speech would not be the same. Because she would have grown for another, like, how many years? Another 20 years, and she would maybe, she might have become a bit more reserved. So let's just enjoy her while she's like that. That was amazing. And, you know, I think she has painted for me a picture of what life used to be like. Even though I wasn't there, I could easily relate to a lot of the things she mentioned.
I am particularly grateful and thank God for the life of my sister. Most of you don't know how close our lives to be. I am her father today. Father, myself, brothers. I would always said it takes the deep to know the deep. Her late husband and myself went to the same primary school from day one, all same school. And we grew up like that. It's a poor lover. God always planned every one of us journey in life. Let me start by singing, to join me, I will sing it in Yoruba dialect. Eshe ni bita ti pere.
Eshe ni bita bade. Adupe o Jesu.
That is a virtuous woman. I don't use that word recklessly. That is a virtuous woman. She went through thick and thin to bring up these children to me. Because I know it all. I was the first to return from Britain. When they came back, they met me in Nigeria. In fact, they stayed with me. We were so close, my late husband and myself. In fact, my best friend came. Taye, Akifolani, Kaide, Ogumaki, and my sister. They've been coming, God knows for you, to demonstrate that you have the Buba keys here, you have the people that is here. I'm sure, kindly, wherever she is now, she must be taking up today. She ought to have been here.
A round of applause for Uncle, ladies and gentlemen. Uncle, how easy was it to go home with Auntie Iwa? You know, all that time, you know, how easy was the first day? You know, were you apprehensive? Were you wondering what Mom was going to say? How was it? Just paint a picture for us.
Before you speak. No, my wife also had another mother, Mrs. Olaniyo, who also raised her. That's the house that I went to first and foremost.
Ah.
But for the first time that I set my eyes. No, because she was a mother also. But the first thing is that the first time I met my wife, I told her something in a meeting. We're just having a meeting. The first word I spoke to her was that I'm going to write to your mom. I've never met her before in my life. We've never met each other. She came to the bank where I was working and she wanted to get credit loan. And she sat in front of me. And the first thing that came out from my mouth is that I'm going to write to your mom. It was crazy. Seriously crazy. Because after I said that, I wonder, why did I say that? Number one, I don't know her before. And I didn't know that then I would have to write a mom. Because my wife was in Nigeria and her mom was in England. So that answers your question. And then when I actually wrote mom or spoke to mom, it was the easiest thing. And you see that I call her mom, I didn't call her mother.
You had a soft language.
Definitely. you know, by law, your mother-in-law is your mother. That's what it means. That's why they say mother-in-law. She now has to write over you as, take you as a son. But before I go further, I just want to thank God for your life, Mom. I want to thank God who has kept you safe, who has kept you through all the times, both the low times, the high times, the hard times, and the soft times. I also want to thank God for your friends, those, your families who have been there for you. Even Uncle Lou, Auntie Tai, Auntie Kende, I didn't see Auntie here, Mrs. Fason, every one of them who had been with you, Prophetess Elliot, they have been able to help your journey to be very easy. I want to thank God for the church also that you have sold to. Many people will not know that indeed we can call you Mother Teresa of our own African heritage because of what you do and the way you do things. Now, for me to speak about mommy to me is not just since I met her, she became my own advisor, my confidant. I tell her things more than my biological mother. Because why? Mommy is very, very wise. She's very, very wise. And that also reflects on her daughter. Her daughter is very wise. One of the things that I've seen about mom is that she will listen. You can talk to her from now to 20 hours. She will listen to it. And afterwards, she will dissect it. And what she will come up from her mouth will diffuse everything that you have as a problem in your heart. I think that's a very gift that we must recognize in mommy. And my wife led me to Christ, by the way. But mommy did something that is amazing. She expanded my mind about who God is. She's always saying this. She'll say, oh, mommy, I want your little guru. Church your guru. Initially, I don't like to see people telling me they go to a white garment church or you're not wearing shoes or something like that. And you have to pardon me. Many of us know that a lot of people in those churches, from what we know, is that they used to do things that are not right. But then mommy said something to me one day. She said, oh, mommy, you know, in your church, there are bad people and there are good people. In our church, there are bad people and there are good people. It changed my perspectives about who a Christian is all about. And today, I preach in a lot of celestial churches, even in Nigeria, amazingly. And when I'm preaching to them, I tell them, I said, my mom is also a celestial person. It amazes them, and I can go there and lead everybody to Christ. Mommy, what you have done in my life is immense and is priceless. Because you are not a mother-in-law, you are a mother. Many people do have mother-in-laws that when their mother-in-law is coming. I've been a pastor now for many, many years, so I know what it is. And many people will cancel all over the world. And whether in India, they have problems with mother-in-laws. But I used to tell them, I said, really? I don't have that kind of problem. My mother is not a mother-in-law, she's my mom. She will tell you everything that is right. And like my son said, she's always smiling. She will smile. Even though it's an issue, she will be smiling. And she will be encouraging you. She will tell you that don't worry. God will do it. And that we thank God because you are a prayerful woman. We thank God because you are also resilient. And you are so principled and you are strong. My prayer for you in Jesus' name is that you will grow beyond 118. You see, mommy, the prayer is that every child should be greater than their parents. Mama was 118 when she died. But she was in Nigeria, so she lacked some certain facilities. Myself and my wife were discussing how you will travel, how you will go here, how you will go there. Mommy will go on holiday. She's traveling to this place, going to that place, and so on. Some people of your age, they pack it up. They're waiting for death. In Nigeria, many of them are waiting for death. They think that their time is over. You don't believe that. And this is one of the things you have taught all your children. You are indeed a gem. You are indeed a man in a woman's body. And that's an amazing thing about you may not know. And one thing we never told you or we didn't tell you is that how much we love you and how much we appreciate you. We tell you we love you, but you don't understand it. Because, you know, for us to have a mom who doesn't give us trouble is an amazing thing. And this is one of the reasons, mommy, that I want to say here now. Is that you also taught us about something. And I know my parents taught me that also. But I've seen that you believe that a good name is better than any money. And you believe that the name must not be spoiled. And I've had you many times to say that, say, ah, no, Urukomi ni bajel. And one day I just want to thank you for the beautiful children you've given, you've raised, and I can see that in my wife, Wendy and Shadi.
Your motherly love to all of us, me including your adopted daughter. So as mommy holds the knife to cut the cake, can we just spell the word Jesus? J E S U the house with Iwalola, and mom just said welcome, and I just want to appreciate you, mommy, that you really meant every word of that welcome, because ever since then up till now you've had my back, you've loved me, even when we used to go on our trips when Iwalola and I, when we're doing our study things and we come back home and I'm thinking in my head, oh, she can't touch this, and you just hit me as well that you're one of them. Get in there. What do you think you're doing? So I thank you for loving me regardless. And looking after, even in my error, she did. She had already been quiet. I just want to thank her and appreciate you, mommy, for who you are. For loving me regardless. I love you.
We wish you well today. Your life from here greet you with all our hearts, from every part our love we give to you, length to your days and strength to your ways, blessings be upon your Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome with me the man of the house.
Over to you. Please, ladies and gentlemen, welcome mom's only son. A round of applause then.
Hello, everyone. Okay, so. You know, Shelley, don't sell. Take it easy, though. Okay, so obviously we're here tonight with Mama. As you all know, I love my mom so much. But I'm here to give a toast. And this toast is for long life, prosperity, and good health. That's what we want. Nothing else, nothing more. Quite simple. Okay? So we keep it nice and we keep it simple. No complications. I don't like complications. You know, if you know me so well, you know I don't like complications. I hate complications. I hate speeches. You know, I hate talking, but at the end of the day, it's my mom's thing, so I'm here to say, Mommy, I love you so much. And I'm so grateful that you're alive today. We've been through so much together. It's emotional. But I'm happy I'm here today. So, Mommy, I love you. Mommy, Jane, yeah. Hey, we'll be now. You're okay. Mommy.
Just make sure say everything be fine. Yeah? I will be here for you, no worries. Yeah? I thank you all for coming today. My children, my fiance, Jackson, I see you. My siblings, we've done well. We thank God for everything. Mommy, I love you. God bless.
Microphone.
Hello.
I sold all my belongings, and one day I went to
packs. Any number of stuff now. 4 packs on order. Pick up the food, yeah, now. Because the water that we use is the pocket. When you get there, you get it. You know. When I got to it, I don't it and everybody else. I said, I used to have a dream. I see all of us back at the London.
Yeah.
I'm I'm going to go to the hospital.